near Golda Meir. And Golda Meir said to me, "Are you Jewish?" I said, I don't know, I think not."
Good answer.
And I said, "Why you ask me so?" And she said, "Because you are, you made a very good performance, and you like, you look like a Jewish, really." And I said, I studied before doing this part. I studied a lot." And she said, "Yes, it seems so." The Sika, it's a great, it has been and is a great, great director. And he said to me, "We must do it. You must speak slowly, slowly and soft, because I want to see in your eyes your soul. It's very, very important for me, because I understand absolutely what he wants to see." He said, "You are expressive, because when I look in your eyes, I understand what you feel. So it's very, very important for a movie actor, a movie actor. This it's not the same on the stage, because it's another time, no? Recitazione.
Another type of acting.
Yes, acting. Okay.
Do you have more questions? It's hard to see raised hands.
Do you know if there were any survivors from that period that worked on the film with you, or worked on the film?
I'll take that question. But yes, I mean, you know, this is based on a fictional novel that's based on real events. But not every Jew from Ferrara was deported to begin with, and we see that represented in the movie by the character of the Rebellion Cattolico, who manages to run away with the rest of the family, with mother and sister. And there were about 7,000 Jews deported to the death camps from Italy. At that time, as you notice, the arrests were made by Italian police, not by the Nazis. Eventually they were handed over to the Nazis and taken to Poland, to death camps, mostly to Auschwitz-Birkenau. But there were survivors, of course. Are there? Yes, please. And speak straight into the microphone like this.
First of all, thank you for being here, and congratulations. I really enjoyed your performance. My question is, did you any research in order to for your role?
Try to speak in English, not I'm tired. You
I read the book.
It's interesting to know, perhaps, that the novelist has been my master, my teacher at school, at dramatic art. Yes? Yes. And I read the book, and the book is very... it's easy to understand what's happened to historical context. And what happens, this family closed, you know, by the wall, within the wall, and lui non riesce a entrare in realtà in questa famiglia perché
and in fact he's unable to go into this family.
Sì, cioè è molto facile capire il personaggio, che è uno che cerca di entrare in un contesto di una famiglia molto aristocratica.
It's very easy to understand.
E lui invece è una famiglia piccolo borghese.
The context of this character who tries to walk in, enter in the folds of this very aristocratic family, whereas he belongs to a different class, to a small bourgeois family.
E questa sensazione di essere uno che non arriverà mai a conquistare lei.
And the feeling that he has that he will never manage to conquer her, he'll never get her.
Lo rende terribilmente infelice, no?
Makes him extremely unhappy.
Questa infelicità io ho cercato di recuperarla, perché quando da bambino ero contro mio padre.
And I tried to capture this unhappiness because when I was a child, I was very much against, I struggled with my father.
A big struggle with my father all my life. And my father decided to, he said to me, you must go to the college.
Boarding school.
And I said, I don't want to go. I don't want to go there. And he said, I decided. And you must go. Because I am your father, and I decide. So I hate my father. Really hate. And I've been ever a lonely boy. And before to show in this movie, I decide to remember my situation of the lonely boy and the sadness of the situation. And I try to remember, and after it's easy to discover your sensitivity and love inside.
The generational conflict that's outlined in the movie is key to the historical context. One of the big divides of families facing anti-Semitic discrimination in fascist Italy was that the younger generation was much more aware of what was going on than the older generation, so the conflict was very much there. And at the same time, it's actually very telling what Mr. Capolito just told us about him auditioning for the role and showing up with long hair, because this movie was made in 69, 70, at a time in which another generational conflict was happening, a very strong one. And so this episode of the long hair is very telling of this multiple layers that are very much present in the movie. It's a very Italian movie, very much about Italian history. Do we have other questions from the audience? It's really a wonderful chance that we have to. Ma prego. Sì.
Dati di Simatore, come era come regista, portava la sua esperienza di attore.
The question about De Sica, that he was just as great a director as he was an actor, so...
De Sica was very nice man in the life, but he was terrible on the set. He was crying.
Screamed and yelled.
I saw many actors cry. Please, don't scream to me like that. But I think the director, are so like. Bad, it's bad. Repeat another one. One day, we were shooting in the interior, and De Laurentiis in the theater. And we are shooting at the end of the movie. I discover my best friend in the bed with my love girl. No, it's a loving girl.
My beloved, my girlfriend.
Forgive me for my English. And De Sica say to me, "This is one. For me, is the most important scene of the movie, because I want to see in your eyes all the psychological passage from your astonishment, your completely, you say it's impossible, and after you are really." Understand what happened, and you are angry, and the pain is very, very hard inside you, and you are angry, and you, after you go, it's impossible for you to see again. So he said to me, please go and concentrate. You, and after you say to me, I'm ready to shoot. Okay. I say, Mr. De Sica, I'm ready to shoot. Okay. And we shoot one shot. And at the end, he say, quite good. At the end, when you go out, it's a close-up, you go, a little bit slowly, please. Okay, another one at the end, he said, and I was going to my camerino, come si dice? Camerino.
To my dressing room.
Yes, and suddenly I, in my shoulder, and his voice, the Sica's voice, said, "Boy, you are a great talent." And I was faint.
have a question over here.